that time when it was so precious to her that she's going to share it with him. But see, Jesus came along, and she decided, I need to make this sacrifice, because if I do this, maybe he'll do that. See, sometimes what you have to understand, the more we give of ourselves, the more he will give back to us. When was the last time you showed Jesus how much he meant to you? Cece Wyman said it like this. She said, and though she spoke no words, everything she said was heard as she poured her love for the Master. Sometimes, people of God, in worship, you don't have to say a word. You can just lift up a hand. Sometimes your worship may be the falling of a tear running down your face. Sometimes your worship can simply be a moan or a groan. Have you ever experienced somebody sitting next to you in service that was having a problem with your worship? They sat there wondering what was wrong with you. I'm all right. What's wrong with you? Why are you watching my worship? The disciples, as I mentioned, they got indignant. But Jesus had something to say. I remember, Superintendent, there were times when the disciples, again, had a problem with Jesus and what he was doing. Y'all remember when he was at the well with the woman? When they came back with the food, they were wondering, why are you talking to her? Do you remember the time when the woman, the Canaanite woman, with the demon-possessed daughter, the disciples had the nerve to say, she keeps coming after us. Crazy man, she wasn't coming after you. She was coming after the power. She was coming after Jesus Christ. They weren't coming. She wasn't coming after you. She was coming to see what Jesus could do for her child. Remember when Jesus was going to feed the 5,000? Some of the disciples questioned, man, you don't have enough food to feed all these people. Don't believe me, just watch. Because God is able to multiply. He doesn't do it like we do it. He doesn't see it like we see it. So I just want to remind you that we have to understand that Jesus loves us to worship him.
Spend
Spirit that he will attach to you. Everybody standing. Everybody standing. The aroma of your music, perhaps, first of all, the first call, is there anybody in the house that's not saved? Anybody that's not saved? That's the first call. If you don't know him, this is your call. This is your time. If you come, somebody will meet you at the altar. We don't want anybody to leave here not knowing him. Thank God. It looks like the house is set, and we do thank God. The second call, if your worship needs a little bit more power, a little bit more fragrance, a sweeter scent, this call is for you. We're not saying that you're not saved. We're not saying that you don't know him. But if there's something that you need from God, this call is for you. More power, more strength. The anointing on your life, you need more of it. This is your moment. This is your moment. Does anybody sick in your body? Sick in your body. Come quickly, come quickly. Come quickly, come quickly. Anybody sick in your body? Come quickly, come quickly. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Anybody wants to stand in proxy for somebody? Come quick, come quick. Come quick. God is going to do something real quick.
Hallelujah. All is well.
Keep coming. All we want. But we need this place to go out with a greater anointing.